Welcome to the first match of the evening. We're on Overgrowth, spawning to the bottom left-hand location using the good old extractor, double extractor trick. Playing the orange Zerg, it's Allaryce. And to the top right-hand corner in green, playing Zerg as well. For 1F Academy, it's Wryza. So, ZvZ on Overgrowth, quite interesting. It's quite an old map, we have to say. Looks as if Wryza just wants to go for a hatch first, same as her opponent. Actually, a little bit later with her own hatch than Allaryce already. So just a little bit of an advantage for Allaryce already. Nothing to really speak of, not really that important, I have to say. And yeah, then of course the usual follow-up, Allaryce being greedy as hell, just putting the extractor before the spawning pool. But no problem here, since Wryza has just done the same. So both will actually be equal in terms of the time when the first links and especially speedlings will arrive, because probably both players will just use the first 100 gas in order to get the zergling speed out as quickly as possible. Of course, in some other universe, no, and actually some other more cheeky types of builds, you could actually also try to use the first 100 gas in order to get a quicker layout, but this is usually not what you want to do. Even if you want to get a quick layout, you could do it for getting, for example, quick road speed and everything, but that would be a totally odd and unusual build order here. So in this case, everyone just being predictable as hell. First six zerglings for Allaryce though, so it seems as if Allaryce just wants to ramp up the aggression a little bit here. We'll just have to wait if more zerglings are to follow. She's actually just rallying them into the back of her own two bases, so it seems as if she just wants to surprise her opponent with a little bit more aggression here. Baneling Nest coming up for both players, so Wryza is actually well aware of what her opponent could actually be doing, although she hasn't really seen a lot of stuff yet. Just has an Overlord sitting over here. If she just flew in with it a little bit more, then she could actually see that no drones or only a few drones are mining here, and thus maybe assume that her opponent might be getting some more links up. Okay, two more links after just checking some locations over to the right hand side. Now just sneak over towards the natural base location. Same thing with Wryza here. She just wants to sneak out a few links, but they actually got spotted by that overlord that Allaryce had been hanging or had hanging around there. So first few banelings already in production. Seems as if Allaryce just wants to get into the natural mineral line and then maybe destroy a few drones here. Drones are actually quite split up. I don't really know how much damage she would be able to do so, but here using the F2 command, it seems, in order to get all her units together to fight against this zergling push. Also the two banelings here, where are they? So where are the banelings? Okay, she just realized that she did use the F2 command and then just separated the banelings back towards the front. Also running more and more units towards the front. Has the two banelings out here, so even if Wryza actually had some units prepared to deal with that. Oh, good connection here for Wryza, actually just getting one of the banelings with the help of one drone. Another baneling just explodes into the hatchery here. Not that best, not the best of an engagement here, so Wryza just holds for the moment while Allaryce is just massing links and banelings right at the front doorstep of Wryza here. So let's see what Wryza actually can play against that. Just morphs a lot of her banelings herself, but she still needs some time in order for them to get finished. And now, of course, it's the good old Ling Baneling Micro. So let's see whose execution will actually be better here. So first baneling might actually get taken out by the queens here. Wryza just moving around, trying to secure her links from that one baneling hit that just might cause the destruction. Okay, two banelings just eventually hit the queen, so no real damage done over here. Wryza in the meantime just trying to get the good baneling connection, just quite does not get it. And yeah, the Cena's just even out once more, with Wryza maybe having a little bit of an advantage since her own links just need a little bit shorter in order to arrive at the front, and Allaryce being supply blocked at the moment, needing to produce three overlords at once. In the meantime, Allaryce just decides to make the best out of her links, just takes out one queen over at the third base, cannot actually attack the third base itself. In the meantime, we have more units just running in, and again Wryza getting one good baneling connection over here, just killing one baneling with the help of one of her own links. Allaryce just trying to get a good connection with her one baneling. Wryza also moving around with her two banelings. Well, a decent hit over here. Ooh, unfortunately the explosion just made by hand over here didn't really get anything over there. So Allaryce still trying to attack the third base, might now eventually be able to get it. Is also spawning a few more banelings over here, while only a few more banelings being morphed over there. Wryza cannot really afford to get over here and save the third base, and the third base falls. Actually, quite an important hit here for Allaryce, since she hasn't been taken her own third base behind it. So she really needed to get that damage done in order to stay inside the game. But now she's actually equaled out most of the supply counts and everything, so it seems as if she's kind of okay. Also teching into a Roachhorn, still on two bases though, so let's see if she will manage to actually get out enough units in order to overwhelm Wryza here, since once Wryza actually manages to clear up the push by Allaryce, I think she should be kind of okay. As long as Allaryce doesn't bother to take a third base in the next few seconds, that is. So, a few roaches are already out, so with a few more roaches coming in, I think this push should be as good as held. Allaryce just making sure that Wryza will not be able to take a third base over here. In the meantime, she now prepares to get a third base off her own, so finally decides to transition into the mid-game. So we have roaches now moving across the map. Okay, banelings not really being a problem for those roaches. Moving towards the third base location, Allaryce realizes she can't really fight straight up against these roaches, does not really try to do a run by. Maybe a little bit later, but in the meantime, Wryza will also take her third hatchery just only a little bit after Allaryce herself. So, well, it seems as if it's even out quite nicely here. I think Wryza could actually just make use of all of these roaches, trying to put a little bit of pressure towards Allaryce's bases, but maybe she doesn't want to risk a run by that might just kill her hatchery over here. In the meantime, Allaryce just realizes, well, if most of the roaches are standing over here with my overlord just seeing all of them, I might as well just do a little run by over here. Okay, one baneling hit, it seems, just killed a few of these zerglings over here. Zerglings still running in. We'll probably get a queen kill over here. No! Just barely not. Oh, the queen just burrowed here. Nice move by Wryza there, saving the queen over here. She even made one queen more, I think, for the third base. Once it finishes up, so she would have already had one to spare anyways. But yeah, nice move there by Wryza, just burrowing this queen just in time in order to save it from the Ling attacks. So a lot of army forces over here at the third base. No chance for Allaryce to do anything over here, but of course, with the overlord sticking around, she will always just have a good idea of where the units are, so that's probably why the Ravagers are already morphing, so that Wryza will be able to just finally get rid of that annoying overlord. In the meantime, we have a little push in preparation over to the right-hand side. Seems as if Wryza just wants to get into the third base, but I think... No, actually not. Allaryce actually had no idea, so this hit comes mostly by surprise. We still have some banelings around, but it's mostly roaches, so the banelings won't really deal any much damage. Allaryce just reacts quickly enough in order to get her forces towards her third base, and no real damage has been dealt. So again, a little bit of a pause to catch some breath here, and in the meantime we have Allaryce transitioning into the lair, while Wryza has actually not done any of that sort. She already has a macro hatch up, which could actually kind of help her getting the minerals low, but well, producing a lot of lings will not really help her out that much right now, since a lot of roaches are already out. I mean, if she had committed to only upgraded lings right from the get-go, she might actually be able to just overwhelm these roach forces, and maybe even with additional run-bys, just kill off a lot of important structures in the main base at the same time, with just massing lings. But having committed into a lot of roaches already, I don't really think she will be able to make that much use of that hatchery for now. But of course, she probably just planted it down just in order to get her mineral count a little bit lower while the Ling Baneling count was still going on. So has not taken all of these gases. One extractor is finished, but there are no workers in it so far. So there's a lot of gas actually missing. And in the meantime, we have Allaryce transitioning into the Spire, which is of course always a good thing to do if your opponent is going into a lot of roaches and ravagers. She's already accumulating a lot of resources, so she will be able to just get out 11 muters at once, as we see right now, and 11 muters are quite a flock. So it's actually almost impossible for Wryza to fight straight up against these muters, since she will not really be able to hit the muters at all. I mean, the Ravager Biles can theoretically hit a muter force in the sky, but of course the muters would just have to stand still completely. And since muters are very quick, a good Zerg player should just actually never lose any muter to any Bile. So, like I said, it's theoretically possible, but actually not really. So, there's the counter push now by Allaryce. She has a lot of roaches, quite a nice mix here. Some Zerglings left from the opening, a few roaches as well, plus also the additional muters here. In the meantime, Wryza just realizes, okay, these units can't really fight against that army head-on, so I might as well just send them towards the third base, try a run-by attack over here. At the same time, Allaryce just realized that Wryza tried to take a fourth base, will tear it down, just retreats with all of her units in order to save her third base. But a lot of workers have already been killed over here, so very nice attack there by Wryza. Not only getting a lot of time, not only winning a lot of time here, but also getting seven drone kills. The question is, of course, how did she use that time? She mostly used it in order to get an infestation pit out, but she doesn't really have that much. Well, she has some gas over, but she will now have to wait for the infestors and will hope for the money fungal, I guess, in order to get this down. I mean, her ground forces are superior to those of Allaryce. So if it really comes down to a straight-up engagement between the ground forces only, Wryza should just actually easily take down all of Allaryce's forces, and will now eventually even do so. So, well, the muters, of course, are still the big problem, raining the glaives from above, and with that kind of, with that amount of muters here already in the mix, I mean, you can just see how quickly the army just melts against this. So I think, I mean, actually, well, the bad thing is that Wryza didn't actually have any time to just get the infestors out. I mean, this fight would have just looked completely different if Wryza had managed to get the infestors out in time and just fungaling or getting a good chain fungal on most of these mutalists over here. But now it seems as if it's mostly done. Wryza just drops below 100 supply. She's still on kind of three bases, but her economy is just tarnished. And no way actually for her to get back. I mean, Allaryce just reproducing a few roaches here. There are some infestors in the mix because they are actually the only thing that Wryza could really build from the heavily from the income and from the amount of gas she still had left. But yeah, I mean, does she even have enough energy for a fungal? Not yet, because she hasn't bothered to research the extra energy, the energy upgrade for the infestors. Yeah, I mean, this is almost for naught. I mean, she's just trying to get herself back into the game, just burrowing the infestors, trying to get the money fungal, which has actually become a little bit easier now, since the infestors are still able to cast all the spells while being burrowed. So it's actually a little bit more difficult for Allaryce to see these infestors coming, and there's the first big fungal and another fungal, so maybe Wryza will just actually get all of the chain fungals down, but not over here. We'll get another small chunk of the army here. This could have actually been quite disastrous there for Allaryce, but I mean, she's still far ahead already, don't get me wrong. I mean, losing all of these mutas would be quite a blow here, but now Wryza is even in the supply cap of 52 while only having 66 supply anyways. 32 of them army, while 98 are mutalists, are in mostly mutalists, and then of course a few roaches. In the meantime, Wryza just tries to take a hidden expansion over here, but it gets sniffed out by Allaryce immediately. No way to take a base over here anyways. And yeah, I mean, Wryza will just not have the means in order to get herself back into the game. I mean, she's still mining up a third base, but Allaryce has already established a fourth, and the other bases are still healthily, well, kinda healthily mining. So if we just have a look at the income tab, we see that it's about 700 minerals more, and especially the gas count, about 800 gas more. And there it is, GG, Wryza taps out, and Allaryce takes the first game. Second match on Echo, spawning to the top left-hand corner in orange. It's our Zerg player, Allaryce. And at the bottom right, we have Wryza in green, posting the Zerg heart after the obligatory GLHF. And then we have the double extractor trick by Allaryce. Not really worth it, but still stylish to do so. So Overlord already moving out, same for Allaryce. Normally you just want to check for your opponent's base here and see whether they have been going hatch first or not, and that's why you usually just send out your first overlords in order to check the natural expansion. Have to be careful though, sometimes if your opponent just reacts quickly enough and you just move in your overlord too far into enemy territory, then they might be able to just snipe off that overlord with a queen, and that's of course always very annoying, losing an overlord that early in the game. So then we have the extractor and the pool coming up, same build for Wryza as well, just a little bit more slowly executed there by Wryza. So nothing all too unexpected here, so I think we're just going to see almost a repetition of the first game here, so probably mostly Ling Bang Ling Wars. And then, well, Wryza actually likes her roaches, so I think she, well, I mean it didn't quite work out for her in the first game, so maybe she'll just change it up, or she just sticks to her guns and just tries her roach build again, just maybe a little bit better, and maybe hitting her opponent a little bit quicker before she can just accumulate that large of an amount of mutas there. Allaryce, though, not really the roach player, mostly trying to go into mutalisks in ZvZ, same as Suno Khazri and Novea. While, like I said, Wryza, more of an roach player, like Mitsukotsu is. So that's just the two different styles we can actually just see clash against each other here. So just the first safety links already in the making. Seems as if Wryza though wants to get really aggressive here, just getting a lot more lings out. Seems as if she just wants to surprise Allaryce here with a quick attack and baneling nests, or maybe she just expects her opponent to do so. So Allaryce, of course, in the meantime, has just seen the first few lings, does not know about, or actually she does, she does know about the baneling nest as well, so she really has all the information she needs in order to deal with the situation. The question is, how is she going to deal with it? Most of the time just letting all of these zerglings standing in the backside so that she can always just get them up, and just making it a little bit more difficult for her opponent to get a better grasp of how many units are actually there. So Wryza just trying to sneak around most of her units over here, but in the meantime we have Allaryce still with two zerglings over here that she might just again want to morph into banelings in order to throw them into the echo line of the natural base. And there we go. So just a sneaky little tactic over here. Same thing for Wryza though. She also just morphs some bandings over here. So let's see who gets the better connection here. Just nice little scout there with the first few links. Has to be careful that she just doesn't give away her push here. So she just sees how many units are actually there. So let's see, these could actually be good. This could actually be quite interesting hits here. Wryza unfortunately not watching at the moment, so just moves forward with one banding over here. But two queens, and actually now a third one, are already in position here. So no way for banelings just getting in unharmed, if of course Allaryce just pays attention and focus fires them down immediately. So we have seems as if, yeah, there's the run by, but the banelings unfortunately just a little bit too slow in order to get those. Might actually be able to just get these banelings, but that would actually be only just a small trade here. So Wryza just trying to get into the third base, but it's not there yet, so no way for her to do any harm here. Allaryce again just having wonderful overlord spread here, so she actually has all the important parts of the map in sight. She will always know where her opponent is, just moving her army for now. And actually, this could be just a disastrous hit over here. Ooh, not getting quite the connection she could have actually got here, but it's still quite nicely done. So in the meantime, we have Wryza already trying to get a third base a little bit earlier than her opponent here. But Allaryce now standing in front of her gates, just sending in one link in order to get a good idea of how many units are there and what Wryza has in order to defend that little push over here. Allaryce could have just actually tried to around these links by for now. Ooh, this baneling really got a decent connection over here, but two more banelings of Allaryce are already entering the fray. So Wryza just has to retreat for now, but it seems as if this push should be mostly stopped. So, nice little advantage here. Ooh, again, a decent, well, very nice banging connection actually over here. And more units being rallied across the map by Allaryce here. Not more units being produced by Wryza. It seems as if Wryza was just pretty positive that she had held this push. And so she just wanted to get back into droning, just produced 8 more drones. To get up her economy and getting that little advantage, which might now just turn out to be the disadvantage eventually, since now she just hasn't got that many units out. In the meantime, Allaryce is actually transitioning into a Roach Warren here. Quite interesting choice there. As we said, it seems as if Allaryce just also wants to mix up her own style a little bit to not become too predictable over here. Woo! Wryza just getting in with the Baneling. Could have actually also gotten a nice connection over here, but nicely trapped this one little Zergling over here, just trapped this little Baneling right between the minerals, so it couldn't really get towards the big army chunk and eventually just died to the attacking Ling. A nice little trade over there. So Wryza is still ahead in supply. I mean, where the hell is it? Oh, that's just because all the roaches were in production. So now the first few roaches are out, so it seems as if the time of Ling Baneling is almost over here. So the roaches just killing the Banelings immediately. Allaryce just realizes what's up and needs to retreat right now. Just wants to go for another counter push just to get her, just to buy herself more time. I know. I mean, she knows that she won't really be able to deal that much damage with her links eventually, but of course she can just force her opponent back, can also just get the best amount of damage with these links done. And I mean, it's still 5 workers already and also a queen, so wow, this really paid off. Allaryce just buying herself a lot of time here and also getting significant damage dealt at the same time. Woo, this is way more damage than Wryza should have actually let her make here. So now finally getting the typical, well, for Wryza, typical burrow upgrade. But in the meantime, Allaryce, like I said before, just got herself enough time in order to get the third base out, is now transitioning into Spire once more. So we just have the roaches to help her transition into this, well, kind of mid to late game stage. So she wouldn't get overwhelmed by too many roaches easily. So that's just why she has a few additional roaches in here. Makes it a little bit more easier for her to just stay alive to roach pushes like these, and then transitioning into Mutas a little bit more smoothly here. It seems actually she could just easily take out this force though. I don't really know why she retreats here. I mean, she could just easily surround all of these roaches using her links, and now she does finally, so that the roaches won't be able to get away and all of this army will now finally get killed off. But Allaryce just actually just needs to micromanage her roaches a little bit more forward in order for all of these roaches to shoot. But it doesn't even matter. Wryza just actually losing all of her standing forces here. Now trying to deal the same amount of damage to her opponent that Allaryce just tried to deal to her and actually succeeded. In dealing to her a few minutes ago. So she just sends in a few links here, gets 8 workers in total before Allaryce finally, 10 actually, before Allaryce finally arrives at home. So that really is significant loss here. And now Wryza again in the worker lead has also now managed to get up a third base and will now probably just start to saturate it. But the Mutalisks might be the big problem. In the meantime, Allaryce managed to get her spire up. Had four mutas in production, so 4 mutas not all too problematic for now. And Wryza will actually get a very early warning here because the 4 mutas just bothered to attack this overlord over here without even killing it. Seems as if, okay, Wryza will just lose there. Maybe just, no, actually, I think you can't really get onto this cooling tower, so no, it just will get killed anyways. And, well, for now, the mutas are not that big of a problem. It's only 4 of them, and Allaryce is not really actively using them until... was not really actively using them until now. But 5 more mutalists in production. Wryza, again, just wants to deal with the mutas by building an infestation pit first, and maybe later getting into Hydralisks. This time around, she gets the... Pathogen lands the energy upgrade for the infestors a little bit quicker than last time. So again, I mean, she has Burrow already. If she just manages to sneak up with the infestors towards these mutalists and just get the money fungal, which is, like I said, actually a little bit easier now, since the infestors can just cast all of their spells while being burrowed. Then she might actually be able to just take out all of these mutalisks, which would be a disastrous loss for Allaryce here. Because then Wryza should actually be able to overwhelm her opponent on the ground in the long run, since she will just have the more sufficient ground units with roaches and hydras, while Allaryce is now only investing into mutas and will only have the ground forces that she built from the beginning to help her to get into Mutalis. But she already gets into a fourth base, just checks for the fourth base. That's actually the most important role of the Mutas until they get to a critical mass, if you actually manage to do that, is that you just want to fly around with them, checking for other bases, denying them. Same over here, she has the roaches in position, so she makes absolutely sure that her opponent will not be able to just get any bases out and playing catch up in the economical game. Yeah, now just checks for hidden expansions as well, because of course she's just a little bit worried seeing that Wryza is not even trying to get a fourth base up, it seems, because she didn't kill any sorts of units over here. Ooh, Roach is just being in position to kill off a few Zerglings that try to do a run-by attack over here at the fourth base. Might actually be able to take this out just barely before the Mutas and the Roaches arrive. This is a lot of hit points, and we also have some Roaches coming from the left-hand side as well. Wryza just decides to move out, unfortunately has to move through almost all of her opponent's forces, and actually will almost lose all of her little army, or her little hit squad, over to the left-hand side. So again, Allaryce just keeping everything under check, so she just knows that there's still no fourth base over here. We'll just fly over with the Mutalists to check for the fourth base location over here as well, as we can see, and also for the hidden location. Yeah, just having set all the ready points, she really wants to make sure that Wryza is not getting back, is not getting her economy back up. So, and she makes totally sure of that. I mean, just have a look at the map vision as well, just excellently done here. I can't really see Wryza getting back into the game unless it's really going to be the money fungals. I mean, fungals together with quickly set Ravager Biles can actually just wipe out a complete Muta force, and not only that, also forces on the ground can just get killed pretty easily here. So if she, I mean, everything just comes down to the execution and to that one big engagement between this army with the infestors and the army of Allaryce with a lot of mutas in there. Allaryce in the meantime also transitioning into ultras. I don't know if she's actually seen the infestors or if she just expects them to be there, since they are just kind of a natural counter towards her muta play. But yeah, ultralisks of course will not be stopped by Fungal. Ah, there's the Nidus Network in here, so let's now see where the Nidus Network will be planted down. Where the hell are... does she even have vision? I mean, where does she really want to go? In the meantime, okay, after loading up all of these units into the Nidus Network, the run-by of Allaryce just hits the natural base of Wryza. So unfortunately, it seems as if Wryza just has to unload all of the units back outside of the Nidus Network here just in order to secure her natural base, but only after having lost 10 workers in the meantime. And like I said, I mean, I don't even know where she really wants to put down that Nidus Network. I mean, her vision just only goes over to here. Okay, there is something. Oh, she has a changeling over here. Nicely done. So now actually all of the army will spawn right inside the natural base of Allaryce. No way to stop this Nidus Worm from happening. Now she just sends it in and just kills it right before the first queen comes out. Well, the plan actually was for Wryza to just get the queens out first and then to... transfuse this over here, and now we have the first ultralisks out, actually 6 in numbers, and nothing for Wryza really to do with that. Okay, just scouted the Nidus Network attempt over here, but no chance for Wryza to actually ever get any of these units out. In the meantime, just nicely done. That would have actually been also quite a nice move here, just making your opponent thinking that a Nidus would go down. In the meantime, you just use all of your army and just walk across the map, because the distances are not that long anyways. But she didn't really do that, so again, just gets a lot of her army killed. I mean, we have 60 supply difference here. It's 136 to 82. And especially the ultras, I mean, there's just nothing in Ryza's army that can actually deal with the ultralisks and the mutas together. And is that Wryza just... is that... okay, Wryza just throwing down a Nidus Network over here at her natural base. I don't really know why she's doing it. Probably just because she wants to be there a little bit quicker with her units. But even while unloading, the units would just die one by one. I mean, there's not really much that Wryza can do from here on out. She just unloads all of her army units in the main base, will now try to take the engagement. But like I said, I mean, there's just nothing she can do against all of these units. She doesn't even have a real anti-air beside the queens in order to deal with the mutas. The ultralisk will not get stopped by Fungal and will just chop through everything, yeah? Uncontested on the ground, no problem whatsoever. Expect to see GG any minute here, ladies and gentlemen, because there's just nothing to stop that Zerg flood. So finally, the army units are moving inside Ryza's main base. Will take it out eventually. Ryza just desperately tried to get into mutas, even gets 20 mutas, I think, out at once. So this is actually a nice move there by Wryza. So finally, after almost everything got killed in the natural and in the main base, especially all of the important tech structures, Wryza finally manages to clear everything up. I mean, these mutas now are the last saving grace for Wryza, but Allaryce doesn't even care. She just moves in all she got, will now actually lose the muta fight here. No chance for her to win with her mutas against the ones of Wryza's. Even despite the upgrade, no, there's actually no upgrade. Yes, actually there is an upgrade advantage for Allaryce, but yeah, I mean, it will take some time to kill off all of these ultralisks. What is still left? I mean, where are the last remaining structures? Okay, over here, there's one base. But yeah, I mean, it just doesn't work. I mean, we've seen this before in other games of the FSL, where players tried to kill off ultralisks using mutalisks, and it just doesn't work. It just doesn't. It just takes too friggin' long, even if you have a large flock. And now Allaryce even having some corruptors out that will help her deal with these. And that's it for Wryza, and Allaryce takes the second game as well. It's Vani Research Station for the third map of this best of five. In the bottom position we have Allaryce, and to the top it's Wryza. Wryza being down 0-2, she needs to win 3 in a row in order to take this best of five home, which is quite a task to achieve. Well, it seems as if she chose Vani for a purpose, so let's see what she can make out of it. Again, hatch first for Allaryce. Well, I mean, it's not that uncommon on that map, especially since you have the backdoor expansion, the back pocket expansion, as it's also sometimes called. So the only thing you really need to protect in order to keep your two bases safe is this ramp towards the main, which is just a small ramp, so you only need a few units in order to keep it defended and to keep everything safe inside that main base and natural base location. So the same thing also going on for Wryza, going into extractor afterwards and planting down the pool somewhere eventually. Here we go. Same thing for Allaryce, again, also being quite far ahead already. I mean, if you just have a look at that, this spawning pool just came way later than that of her opponents, by on Riza's side, that is. So, already getting a small little advantage here. Still, on this map, it's more problematic to attack with Ling Baneling early on, since, like I said before, in order to get towards the natural base, if your opponent takes an early third base, it makes things way easier for you to attack with a mass Ling Baneling flood. But unless they do so, in order to get some damage dealt, you need to get up that ramp. And holding a ramp is usually always easier than attacking it. So only a few banes are actually enough in order to just take out a lot of links that try to get through here. And if you just send in links one by one or two by two, you can just have your own links up here in order to just eat them up before they can get close to the bane links. So yeah, attacking upwards that ramp with Ling Bane is, well, almost suicidal, unless you just have overwhelming numbers and your opponent is just not expecting the push. You can also, if you just have enough queens out already, just block this ramp with two queens, having a few units right behind it, buying yourself some time in order to get more units out, maybe even planting down a spine crawler to make extra sure that no one gets up here. So like I said, it's very difficult to get upwards that ramp, dealing a lot of damage with Ling Baneling, unless of course you just surprise your opponent or have superior numbers in forces. So actually we see that Wryza is now even blocking that ramp with an evolution chamber, really wants to make sure that her opponent will not be able to harass her early on. So there it is, the first attempt to get upwards that ramp. Allaryce just realizes what her opponent is doing and that she already has a lot of zerglings out. So she just retreats for the moment, will try to get some banelings in nevertheless, and is again just using a lot of zerglings, or just morphing a lot of zerglings in order to ramp up the aggression. And I don't know how good this is going to work out for her. I mean, she also plants down an evolution chamber herself, but not close to the ramp, so she won't have the same possibility that Wryza has to seal everything off. And here we have it. I mean, nice little wall off, including the queen. So yeah, it will be quite difficult for Allaryce to make something happen over here. I mean, with enough banelings, she might actually be able to just bane bust through, but even if she manages to do that, she will eventually just lose all of her banelings, or most of them, and then Wryza will just have her standing forces around, and the banelings will just kill most of Allaryce's links here, so this attack will probably just be for naught. Or she just uses it for a soft contain, which it seems to be for now, so Allaryce just wants to take her third base comfortably while denying Wryza her own. And Wryza, mixing things up, just going for the two base spire play, will probably just try to surprise her opponent with a few early muters here, and this could actually work out quite nicely. Her opponent is just only now transitioning into Lair, it's almost done, but only then will Allaryce be able to just start up the Spire, while Wryza's Spire will just be so much earlier. And I think this time around, maybe even Allaryce doesn't really want to tech that early. Ooh, actually going into Hydralisks here, quite interesting. Don't know if she just already is expecting her opponent to go into Spire on two bases, which is not that uncommon of a build, once you just realize that your opponent is not trying to move out to get the third base secured. Then it actually is a possible build to worry about. Or if she just wants to have the Hydralisk then in order to get Lurkers out. We'll see what she actually just wants to do. So Spire is going to finish up. Wryza just managed to get barely 500 gas up, so it's only going to be 5 muters. Around 5 muters for the meantime. Yeah, and there we have it. The Lurker then. So Allaryce is quite nice here, just trying to do something different every game, and this time around just trying to get through everything here with Lurkers, it seems. But yeah, Lurkers might just not be the right choice against a player who's two base muting. Still, I mean, it's the really critical thing right now is that there's actually not much anti-air inside Allaryce's base. Seems as if Allaryce is not even thinking of the possibility of a two base muter play, because she hasn't even thrown down any spores. Maybe she just wants to wait for the confirmation anyway, so just saying, well, there might be muters, yeah, but I haven't seen any yet. I have all of my overlords in position, so once the muters move out, I will just get a warning early enough in order to plant down spores at that point in time, which would also make sense, so just waiting for them. And she's already getting some Hydralisks out, which she usually just wanted to get in order to get some Lurkers out, but well, once she realizes what her opponent is doing, she might just as well attack with her Ling, Bane and Hydra Flood, since like I said before, there's just no way that Wryza could just get an annoyingly big amount of muters out that early on, since she just doesn't have the 3 base economy in order to do that. So, Mulan's now ravaging the natural base, flying over here, just trying to kill as many drones as possible. In the meantime, the Hydralisks just walk in between the two forces, so Wryza just retreats back into the natural line of her opponent, trying to deal one more damage over here. Actually could get down the hatchery here if Allaryce just doesn't get enough Hydralisks and the Queens up. Woo! Should actually, I feel, just move the Queens over in order to help her to transfuse this base over here. Will Wryza actually get it down with just 7 Mutalisks? Ooh, it seems that just barely she might be able to get it through. Does not focus it down, does it now? And flies out, losing a lot of muters here, but I think that was totally worth it. Just getting her opponent down to a 2-base economy, mostly. And if you just have a look, it's even less workers now for Allaryce. Just 10 workers less, well, 9 right now. And yeah, Allaryce just does the counter push here, just realizes, wow, losing one of my bases is really such a big hit. I need to deal damage myself. Can't really let my opponent sit on 3 bases while I just try to retake my own third. That would put me too far behind, so I really need to deal some damage over here. Okay, tries to get the damage done by morphing in some more Banelings and Lings. Well, the Mutas already trying to focus fire down. All of these Banelings will eventually get them before they even reach creep, and now Wryza can just try to tear apart all of Allaryce's standing forces. Well, the biggest part for Allaryce is not only that she needs to retreat right now, the biggest part is that she couldn't really deal any significant damage whatsoever. And like we said, she's still behind tremendously in economy, only now trying to take her third base once more. It will just take ages for her to get it up, and then finally just resaturating it. While in the meantime, Wryza could actually just easily take a fourth base, which he now does. And yeah, Allaryce's only hope is probably just trying to mass a lot of units here. Okay, now trying even to get some Lurkers out. Don't know how helpful Lurkers will be. Well, I think maybe 3 to 4 of them will not hurt in the engagement. Especially if she has some anti-air in order to keep these mutalisks from getting on top of them. So this time around we have a lot of queens over here. Wryza just trying to deal more damage to your opponent, even getting 13 more workers that were just long distance mining from that natural base here. So Allaryce just realized that her opponent is trying to get a fourth base. Has she seen it? No, she hasn't yet, but is probably expecting that move. So she's already brought her Lurker into position. Lurkers actually just kill Lings and Banelings pretty quickly. So they might just deal a lot of damage to them on the ground. But like I said before, I mean, there's not much to attack the Mutas. And we're... Ah, okay, there are the rest of the Hydras, because that force just was not scary for the Mutas at all. Okay, now just moving out, trying to chip off a Hydralisk here or there, maybe even getting a Lurker here or there before it can finally burrow. And there Allaryce finally gets her position. Now that's quite fortified now, with the three Lurkers around and the Hydras just swarming about. She might just be able to actually get those done, but the biggest problem right now, all of the Hydras just die in one big Baneling explosion. And now, Allaryce just has nothing left in order to fight those Mutas. Mutas just eventually taking out all the units. And again, no real damage being dealt. Finally, four workers die, but that's just all she got. Well, she actually just managed to get Ryza's economy, well, not really down to her level, but at least getting a little bit closer. I mean, the biggest problem was losing the long distance mining drones over here. If she hadn't lost those, she would now be on equal terms economy wise. But after losing those, she really needed to deal more damage than what she dealt. So, let's see what she can do right now. I mean, Wryza just going for the counterattack. There's still a lot of Hydralisks around, but the Lings might actually just keep most of these Hydras busy while the Mutas then just rain the glaives from heaven. And, okay, nice little spread out here by Allaryce, just trying to get better concaves, trying not to take too many of those hits from the glaives that just jump from target to target. And in the meantime, yeah, Wryza just does the same thing once more. I mean, there's not much protecting these Hydralisks, which is just the biggest problem for Allaryce here. She has the means to take out the air army, but she doesn't have the meat in order to keep these things from happening. Seems that Wryza just wants to split up these units. Okay, getting the queen kill, getting also all of the Hydralisks killed, which is just the most important part. And now we can already see the supply difference here, 150 almost to 70. So, well, I don't really think that... I mean, now in the meantime, we also have Wryza on four bases with a fifth base going on. Allaryce just barely on three, will now even lose the third base over here. Just too many Mutas raining justice from above. And not much more for her to do, so only a few roaches sticking around, but nothing to attack the air. Also these two queens, once Wryza just moves around and actually commits to attack that queen and will just die in an instant. 15 more workers have gone down, and I'm sorry to underhype this, fans of Allaryce, but this game is done. No way for Allaryce just to come back into this. Ah, okay. The obligatory infestors hoping for the money fungals getting the mutalists as well as all of the other units and then just chain fungling them. But she just gets on top of them, not much enough energy for fungal left. And Wryza takes her first game in this best of five series, just getting shortens the distance to a 1-2. Newkirk Precinct is our fourth map of this best of five, spawning to the top right hand, the bottom. There is no top. So spawning to the top, to the bottom right hand corner in orange, we have Allaryce, and to the bottom left in green, it's Wryza. Okay, and Allaryce this time around not doing the extractor trick, quite interesting, but goes for a very early extractor. Yeah, that's why she doesn't do the extractor trick, because she wants to go for some cheesy play. Let's see how this is going to work out. I mean, this is actually a good map to do it. The rush distances from one natural towards the other are not that big. I mean, there are smaller distances on several other maps, but it's not like the largest distance, so to speak, of. And the entrance towards the natural base is just wide ass. It's just a huge ass ramp. So it's easy to just get up here. It's actually impossible to just wall it off in time for that early Ling aggression. And these Ling rushes have actually become a little bit more potent in parts, since it's now easier to get the setup up time-wise, because you start with 12 workers in Legacy of the Void now, but your overlords don't move any faster. So it actually just takes the same amount of time for overlords to get over towards the natural base and realize that there is no natural base. But in that at that point in time, the Lings are already out running across the map. So now it depends on what Allaryce is actually doing. Yeah, just nicely done, just moves around the typical scouting patterns of overlords or early Lings or drones. So Allaryce really wants to surprise her opponent with a lot of Lings and Banelings rushing in, and thus far Wryza doesn't really have that much against it. I mean, she's just started Ling speed. Her opponent's Ling speed will be done in just a few seconds. She hasn't thrown down a Baneling nest yet, and this base is totally vulnerable. But it's actually not the most important part, that Allaryce just wants to attack, and she does not do that. Well done here, because that would have actually been the major mistake. Just giving Wryza enough time to set up her defenses in the main base, and she doesn't really let that happen. She just moves in with all of the Lings. Ooh, lets most of the Lings actually get surrounded, but just unfortunately Wryza just tries to mineral walk most of her units here. And now even it seems as if this was a small little mistake here, that she just cancelled her own spine over here, so I think that really was a misclick. Allaryce unfortunately still letting a lot of her Lings getting caught here, but Wryza has already lost 10. It's still just damage that would be kinda okay-ish, and in the meantime we have Allaryce already transitioning into a second base as well. But yeah, I mean, this damage is kinda okay. It equals the economy up, so if Allaryce actually just manages to get a little bit more damage done, not letting Wryza getting this worker lead up again, and then also manages to transition into this hatchery safely, then I think she should be quite fine and even in an advantageous position. But until that, it's not over yet. I mean, a lot of things just depend on all of these Baneling hits, and of course having three Banes around while Wryza does not even have her Baneling nest out is also disastrous for Wryza here. So yeah, she now just tries, it seems, to get another Baneling nest up here, but yeah, this one is going to be taken out. This one is just going to take forever, and with her own Ling production against the 10 more Lings, 12 more Lings now, that are being rallied across the map, Wryza even producing 3 more drones? Like, what the fuck? I mean, where did these 3 drones come from? I mean, Wryza, of course she needs to get her echo up a little bit, but I mean, she must be aware that her opponent is just producing Lings and Lings and Lings. Well, GG, well played, and Allaryce takes the fourth game for the 3-1 victory.